If he wanted to, he would, and I'm going to tell you why. I really need to hype up some men that I've dealt with recently in the past few years, and I have actually been through several relationships that were actually not that healthy or just not a good match for me, so now I'm really learning my standards and what I truly deserve and want in a person, and I've also outgrown people too, so I think you guys can probably relate with that as well. But I'm going to give you story times about why you should never settle, and if he wanted to, he would. So firstly, I'm going to tell you a story time. So this was actually several years ago at my sister's wedding, and I was actually really excited to go there. It was in Atlanta, so it was a destination wedding for everyone, even the groom and most of the family. And I was actually the maid of honor in this wedding, which is fabulous because I love my sister so much, and I was so excited too because her and her husband, well, her fiance at the time, they were such an adorable couple, and they got together actually several years ago, really hit it off. They actually worked together for a little bit and got together, and then they were together for several years and then moved to go to law school together. And then once they were in law school and they graduated, they finally got married and engaged too. And I was just so excited because they were so happy and the perfect couple for each other. I'm so happy for my sister too because she truly deserves that. And so I was really excited for her and really trying to help her as her maid of honor as well. And also what happened too was when we went there to the wedding, I knew that my sister was trying to see if like there was anyone single, a part of the bachelor party, because I was single at the time. And when I went to the wedding, they were talking about that I was like one of the, I think I was the only single bridesmaid. I'm almost positive I was the only one. I might be wrong, but I'm almost positive I was. If not, I was one of the only ones. So there was only a few of us. And I think it was also the same things with the groomsmen too. So don't quote me on that either, but there wasn't a lot of single people there. If that makes sense, I remember we're part of the bridal party. But whatever, everyone was so nice anyway. So when we got there, everyone was just like doing their duties and having fun as well. But I was really trying to be a good sister and maid of honor for my sister. So what ended up happening was we had met several groomsmen during the time we were there, and also the bridesmaids, because I didn't actually know a lot of them. There was only like one of them I truly knew. Like the rest were people from her law school or even I think work, so they were more local. So I actually met a lot of people there that I didn't know, which is totally fine. I'm fine with that. But yeah, so happy for her too. And nothing but nice people. And also too, the only other person I really knew was the matron of honor, which was someone local for me, and that we've known for my entire life, so that was actually perfect, and she helped a lot too. And what also happened, so of the day of the wedding, I was trying my best to be there for her, but she had like a full like wedding planning team too, my sister, so I didn't really need to do a lot, if that made sense. It was actually kind of nice, but I was willing to help more, but she didn't really need a lot of help, if that made sense. So, and she didn't also need to do a lot of things either, but the on the day of the wedding, the only thing we really had to do was like bustle the dress, which I actually failed. And the wedding planner had to fix it because me and the matron of honor did it the wrong way, but I had never been a maid of honor until then. So, probably my own fault. But anyway, we followed the video and we did it upside down, but we didn't realize it was upside down, like her gown. But anyway, funny story, right? We messed it up, but the wedding planner caught it. So she's like, hey, wait a second, you need to fix it. It wasn't obvious, if that made sense. So my fault. Anyway, we were waiting for the wedding and everything and having a good time. And once the wedding rolled around, everything went pretty smoothly. Little to no drama. There was just a little bit of drama, but pretty normal. But however, I was doing pretty well. The only thing is I wish I ate more that day and drank more because I was a little tired and hungry at the end of it, but that's okay. So once we actually got to the wedding, we stood up with the groomsmen and took pictures, and we started to talk to them a little bit, but not too much, if that made sense. Like, we didn't really get to know each other until then. Like, I think you guys can probably relate if you've ever been to a wedding like this. Like, I didn't know any of the groomsmen until I got there, and I only knew one of the bridesmaids. So when I got there, it was all kind of new to all of us. And also I was trying to help my sister a lot too and be there. So what ended up happening was actually at the reception is when things started to take a turn. So I actually was there and I was starting to talk to some of the groomsmen. And one of the groomsmen approached me, which is the one who was actually the best man. And we actually had to give a speech. So we started talking, right? So, because I had prepared a speech and so had he. We were talking and like having a little bit of banter, and I found out that he was single at the time. And yeah, so we were talking and having fun and stuff, and like we were complimenting each other on our speeches and everything too. And then we started talking more after that point and really hit it off. And I found out that he was an entrepreneur, so he was very busy. He didn't live in this state or near me at all, unfortunately, but very good man. And I have to just tell you like how nice this man was. So anyway, this situation is going to show you like if he wanted to, he would. Anyway, so we hit it off and we were exchanging numbers, whatever, that weekend. And but I tried really hard to also make time for my sister because I hadn't seen her a lot recently, because it was like during COVID she got married, unfortunately. So, and it also pushed it back a little bit too because of COVID. Oh yeah, that was horrible, by the way. My sister's wedding got pushed back because of COVID. Awful. Anyway, so at that point we hit it off and he was like, oh yeah, I'd really like to like have you come visit me or something, right, in my state I live in. I'm like, oh, okay, me not thinking anything would happen, right? Because let's be honest, I think we've all been traumatized in our love life. Can you guys relate to that? Like, have you been traumatized by someone in your love life, or like had a situation where you're like, oh, maybe that shouldn't have happened, maybe I shouldn't have done that? Because we've all had situations like that where you just learn and you're like, okay, maybe this doesn't fit me anymore, maybe I deserve better, maybe this isn't gonna work out. So, what ended up happening, we exchanged numbers, right? And I was not expecting anything. No expectations, okay? I was like, oh, it's probably nothing gonna happen, right? Well, nope. So, literally, we were talking all the time, and he was telling me how much he liked me, and he decided to fly me out. And he flew me out himself, he planned it himself, booked it himself. He just asked for my information, basically, and when I was free, which was so cool. And he flew me to his family's beach house, and it was so much fun for the holiday weekend. And he also picked me up from the airport, which was so nice. And also, he planned some dates for me as well. And I made sure I tried to swipe, I actually swiped my card one time, because I insisted on it. But I was like, that was so nice. I've never had that happen either, so I didn't even know what the protocol was for that. Like, do I pay for any of it at all? Like, it was so abnormal to me. And he went out of his way to do that, and like he just cared so much. He also dropped me off too, so I had the best time with his friends and family. Just, I'm just so glad that this family raised this kid right. You know what I mean? Because he was just such a gentleman, and I definitely just think that situation like made me realize, hey, you deserve better, and you've dealt with a lot of people who maybe abused your kindness in the past and stuff, and even like more toxic situations, but maybe didn't realize it was toxic at the time. So if you guys can relate to that. But it didn't actually go anywhere further than that at that point. So I'm really hoping that things maybe will go forward, or even with someone else too. But I just had to tell you that story because you're just so cute. And I just like telling people when they're a gentleman and praising them for it because they truly deserve it. So I think a gentleman makes someone 100 times more attractive. What about you guys? So yeah, if you got good manners and you're a good gentleman person, oh my gosh, million times more attractive, for sure. But yes, I also have another story time too. So I actually, this is after I had a little bit of a toxic relationship that ended. So it was actually a good end to this situation. So I didn't realize how toxic the situation was until I left it, but my friends at the time didn't really like it. Like, everyone actually liked this person at the beginning when I started dating him, but then they were like, at the end of it, they're like, yeah, I don't really like that, you know? So it got to a point where it became bad. So what happened was, once I got out of this relationship, it was very on and off. That was also awful. Anyway, so this was also in college when I was dating this ex. I was more toxic. And then after that point, I was kind of like done. Like, I was like, because I thought we were going to make it work. Well, he wanted to make it work. I thought he wanted to make it work. He said he wanted to make it work, I should say. But I don't know if he was just, like, manipulating me. I don't know. You know how some men are. You can't trust them, right? But anyway, I'm going to tell you. So even if that wasn't the case, it was just not meant to work out. So it was just really tough relationship, and maybe we just weren't compatible. That could have also been too, right? Like, sometimes, or they don't know how to love you. Possibility. Anyway, what ended up happening after that relationship ended was I ended up meeting the best man ever. I worked with his mom. So, yeah, that was crazy. And we ended up meeting, and he actually lived in another state as me. I don't know why this always happens to me, where I fall in love with men who, like, don't live in the same city as me, don't live in the same state or country as me. It's usually the first two. Not usually the third, but there's a pattern here, obviously. Anyway, doesn't matter. Anyway, not saying I wouldn't date anyone from here, I'm just saying I've had better luck out of here. I don't know why that is. Anyway, maybe I need therapy. Anyway, I ended up meeting this man, and he was such a gentleman. It was just a breath of fresh air after, like, such a toxic situation. And I didn't realize how terrible that relationship was until I got in the other one. And then I also regretted not, like, going to therapy sooner at that point, because I was like, I guess I didn't realize, like, how much the last relationship, like, took a toll on me. Have you guys ever related to that? Like, sometimes, like, it just takes a toll on you, and also, like, teaches you to do things that maybe you shouldn't be doing, or put up with things that you shouldn't be doing. So it's sometimes really hard to even, like, recognize that it's toxic and it can impact your life if you don't fix the way that you've been brought up. You know what I mean? Like, you're kind of undoing it, if that makes sense. So I kind of got these traits, and, like, also, like, was used to certain things I shouldn't have been, if that makes sense. So anyway, it was a breath in the fresh air, because I realized that this man was someone genuine when I had a really bad day at work. We were already dating, by the way, okay? I'm just telling you this one story because it stands out to me the most about this person. But what really made me happy was, so he was really busy at work. And he also lived a state away. Like, we lived, like, 4 to 6 hours away, something like that. And we would see each other, like, maybe, like, once or twice a month sometimes, or less, depending on the schedule. But anyway, he was the busiest man ever, okay? This man would go out of his way if anything was wrong, right? So one day I was having the worst day. I don't remember what happened. That doesn't matter. That's not the situation, though. That's not the point of this conversation. So I was having the worst day, and I texted him and told him that. And he was like, do you want me to, like, step out of work and talk to you? Aww, like, that just made me so happy, because, like, I've never once, like, thought that was a thing. You know what I mean? Like, I guess I've never heard someone say that. And he's like, or do you want me to drive there? I'm like, oh my god, you want to drive 6 hours because I'm having a bad day? Like, what kind of man are you? Like, obviously a man. Like, I think I was obviously dealing with a child before, or someone more childish, right? Because I was like, oh my god, like, that was just, like, a for sure thing that I was like, that just made sense to me. I'm like, oh, this is something that I can definitely rely on. This is someone that, like, would be a good parent, right? This is someone that my family would like, right? And that was just a good sign too, that, like, there's better out there. And after that situation, I was like, oh my god, I can't believe what I put up with before that too. And also this other situation too, about the man at the wedding. But definitely keep your standards high when it comes to love. And it's not saying that they have to be someone who is wealthy or famous, the most attractive person in the room. I just want someone who genuinely loves me and puts in the effort. My sister loves too, because that's a big part. My sister and I like this, and she has very high standards. She probably has higher standards than I do, to be honest. So as long as if my sister loves you and approves of you too, and also I want someone who just is willing to go put in the effort for me. It's not about, like, I mean, sure, I do want someone who's stable, but I don't need someone who's, like, a billionaire, you know what I mean? Or, like, you know what I mean? Like, there's some really crazy theories out there where, like, people are like, oh, I only date people who make this much money. I'm like, what? Like, you don't need to do that. Like, sometimes it works, like, where maybe you meet someone who's more wealthy than the other, but I don't think that's a necessity. I think that you have to date someone based on the way they treat you. And yeah, that's about it. Because you can even date people who are wealthy who treat you horribly, right? Like, so, and not saying there's anything wrong with dating a wealthy person, that's fine. But, like, I just want something that's, like, more stable and reliable. And I just know how to weed people out. and I know what my standards are. So, yeah, you definitely don't have to have someone who is, like, the most attractive person either, like I said, but it's just someone who genuinely, and also I do think you definitely have to be attracted to the person, definitely, or else it's not going to work out, probably, or not work out well, to be honest with you. But for me personally, I definitely do need to be attracted to someone too, but like I said, there are a lot of factors that make someone a million times more attractive. Like, if you put in the effort, amazing. If you love me, if my sister gets your approval, a million out of 10. That rarely happens, but honestly, there's been a couple that don't deserve it. Anyway, so yeah, if my sister approved you, it's immediately a yes. Immediately a yes for me. Yeah, definitely. Like, my sister's approval is a yes. Not anyone else's. Like, you should be afraid of her approval. Anyway, when it comes to that situation, I just say that if you wanted to, he would, and he would also communicate with you. You should never have to ask a man to put effort into your relationship. You should never have to ask a man to love you. You may have to ask them to respect you with your boundaries, but that's about it. And you should only have to do that probably one time ever. So after that point, you know, it's just kind of like not meant to work out. And that's the one thing that happened with my last more, remember I told you about that relationship that was more toxic? So it was definitely more like he was saying he was gonna change and then never did. Right? So it was finally nice to see that where like people were genuinely caring about me, and I felt like this person, like these other people genuinely wanted the best for me and wanted to be with me, knew that I was like the prize. I know that sounds weird, but it's a good theory that like if they wanted to put in the effort, they would. There's just no ifs, ands, or buts there. And I do think that one day I will meet the one. Maybe you've already met them, to be honest. I don't know the answer, but I just have to tell the men, you did a good job, you did a great job. And I just think, and for someone like me personally, like I just turned 30, which I know I don't look 30. I always get that I don't look 30 and I get it, but I have definitely higher standards than I did back in my 20s or like when I was in high school, right? Because you're not the same person, if that makes sense. So yeah, do you guys relate to that? Because my standards are not high, and it's not that I haven't gone on dates, because I have, but like if you're not acting right, if you're not making an effort to be with me, why would I want to be with you? Like, you would not make a good parent, you would not make a good spouse. I mean, some people can even like turn a leaf and like do it themselves, but I'm not gonna force you, right? I shouldn't have to show you to care about me, right? But yeah, that's definitely so attractive. Effort is attractive. Yes. I hope you guys like this video. If you want more relationship content and dating content, let me know down below. Hope you guys have a great week. Bye.